All right, everybody. So here we are for our last video now in the series of looking at various organic reactions. This will be a fairly short video looking at what we call hydration and dehydration reactions. In a hydration reaction, water is going to react with an alkene in order to produce an alcohol. And so what happens there is the H and the OH from the water molecule end up attaching to the carbons on either side of the double bond. And so we can see that happening here. Here we have an alkene, here's propene. And what's going to happen is the H and the OH attach to the carbons on either side of our double bond here. Now it is important to note that in an unsymmetrical alkene, such as propene here, the OH is going to add to the carbon that has fewer hydrogens on it. And the H bonds to the carbon with more. And so what we can see is that that means our OH is going to attach to the middle carbon right here, not this outer carbon. It will attach to the middle carbon and end up forming 2-propanol. I know that it says propan-2-ol. That's a different naming convention than we've talked about, but it's the same thing as 2-propanol. The OH will not bond to this carbon to form 1-propanol. We're going to form 2-propanol. But the guts, the basics of this hydration reaction is that you end up going from an alkene to an alcohol. The double bond goes away. And so we end up with all single bonds here and an OH attached to this middle carbon to form our alcohol. As you might predict, a little bit more on the hydration still. In biochemical hydration reactions and in reactions that might happen within our bodies, very often we have a carbonyl group that's adjacent to our double bond. And so like here, here's our double bond here. So this is where the hydration is going to occur. We have our carbonyl group here. Now, one thing to note is that the hydration will not occur here at this carbonyl group. This remains unchanged. This will be unaffected. What is important for us to know is that the H atom will actually add to the carbonyl here. And the OH is going to add, or sorry, will not to the carbonyl, we'll add to the carbon closest to the carbonyl. We call that the alpha carbon. So the carbon that is closest to our carbonyl is called the alpha carbon, and the carbon then one away from that is the beta. That beta carbon is where the alcohol is going to form. And so that's an important biochemical note, that in biochemical hydration reactions, the alcohol ends up attached to that beta carbon, not here to the alpha carbon. And so we do need to note that anytime we see these hydration reactions occurring, if we do have a carbonyl group adjacent to our double bond. As you might predict, a dehydration reaction, just the opposite. In a dehydration reaction, here we have our alcohol. And what happens there is that water is removed. And so when OH, the hydroxyl group, is removed, so is a hydrogen from an adjacent carbon. And then, so that gets kicked out as water, but then a double bond forms between those two carbons in order to form our alkene. So we end up with an alkene and a water molecule as products of this reaction. Now, sometimes there may be an option to form more than one product, and we can see that here. So we can see with this compound here, we're going to remove this OH, and we could remove a hydrogen from this carbon or this carbon. If a hydrogen from this carbon here is removed, then we're going to end up with our double bond between these two, as we see here. However, if a hydrogen is removed from this carbon instead, then we could end up with this double bond forming here. So either one of these could be possibilities. If that does occur, if you end up with this sort of situation, The more substituted double bond, which would be this one, we call it more substituted because there are just more carbon groups hanging off this. This would have two H's hanging off it here. This has one H and then just a bunch of carbon groups here. So this is our more substituted version. That is the one that would preferentially form. And so that is the one that we would see more of. And that's called Zaitsev's rule. It's something that those of you who go on to organic chemistry, we'll see this in a bit more detail if you are going on to that course as you study some of these reactions in more detail than what we're getting into here. Again, we have an issue in biochemical dehydration reactions where sometimes we do have a hydroxyl group that is adjacent to our carbonyl. So remember our alpha and our beta definitions. In these cases, our double bond will actually usually form between the alpha and the beta carbons. And so here our double bond is going to form here. It would not form here. So again, we'd have really two options there because we could either remove our hydrogen here or our hydrogen from here. But in these cases, our double bond will preferentially form between these two carbons here, between our beta and our alpha carbons. And so take a deep breath. We've looked at a lot of different types of reactions in these last four videos. This slide here does sum them all up. And I know that's a little hard to see on the slides. So be aware that I did actually make that slide available as just a PDF itself. So if we go to our organic reactions on the website, let's start from the front page of the website here. So here's again, our front page of the website. Under topic details, we go to our organic reactions, which is what we're looking at now. Organic reaction materials. Here in informational handouts, summary of organic reactions. This handout provides a real nice summary for all the different reactions that we've looked at. Oxidation reduction reactions. So here we have some oxidations. For instance, we talked about how we can take a primary alcohol, go to an aldehyde, secondary alcohol to a ketone, an aldehyde to a carboxylic acid. Reduction reactions that we talked about. We just looked at dehydration reactions and hydration reactions, transfer group reactions, hydrolysis reactions. So all the different types of reactions that we've talked about in these last four videos are summarized on this handout here, which should come in handy for you. On another note, before I sign off for today, take a look as we scroll down here through our topic details. Two more. Take a big sigh of relief. There's a lot of work to do yet, but the end is in sight. This has been a rigorous summer course. It still is a rigorous summer course. Chemistry is hard in the summer. We're packing in a lot of information for you here, but keep churning, keep working. We are almost there. And so keep at it. Couple more topics to look at in the next week and a half or so, but then we'll be there and we'll be done. And so, as always, in the meantime, you stay classy, USM.